Hey everybody, thanks for stopping back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. If you are not new here, you know the spiel. My name is Mindy, and here on my channel, I do mostly speed builds, but I also do game reviews, challenges, let's plays, collabs, and more. So if you enjoy that sort of content, please be sure to check out some of my other videos. Give them a great big thumbs up, and if you enjoy them, subscribe to my channel, and as always, leave a comment in the comment section down below, because I value your opinion. So today's video is a super fun one. This is a collab that I did with Retro Sims, and I love collabs, but I have to tell you, it can be really, really intimidating, and we'll get to that here in a minute. So I just want to tell you like how this kind of came about. So basically, I have seen a lot of like bigger YouTubers, they will make like collabs together, and they'll do like Halloween collabs and Christmas collabs, or they all basically just like build their own houses, and it's just like a whole big thing. And I think there's like 40 or 50 of them, and I was like, why does nobody ever ask me to do collabs? Like, am I not that good? I don't know. So I tweeted that. I was like, why? Like, I want to do a collab with somebody. And Retro Sims commented and was like, I'll do a collab with you. And I'm like, all right, let's do this. And we did. And so just going through, like, talking with each other, we were trying to decide what kind of house we wanted to make. And really, if you check out his YouTube and check out my YouTube, we have sort of similar building styles. So it was kind of easy, I feel like, for the two of us to come together and, like, put together a house. But it's still really neat because we do have different personalities. And so our homes, you know, it's got a touch of his personality and a touch of my personality. And so it was really cool. And as you can see, I just want to point out that flooring right there. Like, when he, so he, basically he picked the house. And I was like, okay, well, you pick the house, so you build the outside. So he built the outside. And when I downloaded this, I was like, oh my god, like, I'm going to F this house up royally. Like, it was so, like, the outside was so good. I was so amazed. Like, he did that. You saw me with the flooring on the back porch. He did that on the front porch. And it took me a minute to figure out how he did it. But when I got it down, I was like, that is genius. Like, who thinks of that? Not me. Retro Sims does. Also, and with the windows, he combined two windows. It was like a window from Snowy Escape, I think. And then there's another window, and I don't remember what pack that window is from, but he combined them together. I mean, it's a really cool looking window, and I was like so amazed. So I get this house, and I'm really, really intimidated. I'm like, I'm going to screw this up. Like, he did so good, and then I'm going to get it, and it's just going to look awful. But the landscaping came together really well. And so let me just kind of explain to you. He built the house and did the front yard. I added onto the back of the house and landscaped the backyard. Inside the house, I did the floor plan, and I did the kitchen, dining room, a child's bedroom upstairs, and a main bathroom, as well as the foyer entrance area. He did the living room, the master bedroom, and the master bathroom. And so we just kind of like equally divided it up and everything, and the landscaping came together really, really well. This is in Brindleton Bay. I think it's a 30 by 20 lot. I could be wrong. Don't quote me on that. And here I'm just making this little path, and I kind of imagine that this path maybe used to go back into like the woods or back to like a park, and the owners of this house decided to just like shut that path off. Like, I don't know, maybe people were trespassing or something. I don't know why I got the idea. I don't, maybe it sounds really stupid, but I thought it was cute. I think it looks really cute because it's like you can see where they blocked it off, and it's like a little bit overgrown, and they've got these old, you know, like wooden broken down fences, but yet this house is like really done up really well. And so we were going, at least I was going for a modern rustic farmhouse kind of thing. And so it took me a while to figure it out, but the outside came together beautifully. I was super proud of it. It turned out really well. I do have to say, these plants that I'm putting down right now, we have this issue where when I download the finished home from his gallery is Dom Kit Kat, by the way. I'll put all of his information in the description box down below, so go follow him on the gallery, subscribe to him, all that stuff. His builds are wonderful. But when I downloaded this from the gallery, my plants were all gone, and I used the testing cheats, you know, true on. I was missing like chairs, I was missing the back door, I was missing the microwave and these plants. And it was really weird because, like I said, I used the cheat and I was missing things. So when you, if you want to download this house, I really highly recommend you doing it because it's a beautiful house. Turned out great. But give us a few minutes, and I really want to talk to him about that and see if we can figure it out, what's going on. See if maybe somebody else can download it. See, make sure it's not just me. You know, just let us figure it out and get it all situated for you guys, and we'll keep you updated on Twitter. So if you really want to download this house, just make sure that you follow us on Twitter, and we can keep you updated on the news with what's going on. Cause yeah, I'm not sure. I know the gallery can be so finicky sometimes, and it's one of those things that I feel like a lot of people look past, but the gallery definitely needs to be updated. And I think, Ian needs to put a little more attention on the gallery. So anyways, we are inside now, and I'm working on the upstairs bathroom. This is the main, bathroom, I would say. And this is a two and a half bath home. And I really wanted to make a third bedroom, but I wasn't able to. I considered extending the upstairs, but I didn't want to extend it too much because I felt like it really took away from what Retro Sims did with the house. And I really liked it. And so we ended up making it, I ended up making it a two bedroom home. So there's a master bedroom with a master bath. And then there is a little girl's room. And the little girl's room, I love it. I'm so excited. It's like for a preteen. So you'll see a little bit how I kind of configured that when we get to that room. But yeah, so I just decorate the bathroom up really nice. And I really struggled with the inside because, again, I was so worried that I was going to screw this up. It was going to look so bad. And I actually hit this like horrible creative block, and I would be like, I told Retro Sims one day, I was like, oh, I'll have this up by like Wednesday. And then like, you know, a week later, I'm like, listen, I'm really struggling here. And I was struggling because I wanted it to look really, really good. I wanted it to kind of like reflect a little bit of his building style and his personality, but also mine as well. And I just, yeah, I wanted to do my best to be thorough and detailed and just have a nice looking home. So I hit a creative block, and I actually ended up doing like the whole child's bedroom at one point and then just completely undoing it. I did the kitchen several times. It was, oh my goodness, like I had to cut so much footage out, and this is still a 30 minute video. It's crazy. My videos are always so long. But yeah, so it was a little bit of a struggle. I definitely, I hit a creative block. So here in the bathroom, the way things are right now does change a little bit, because I wanted to add a washer and dryer, and that's something I try to incorporate in all my homes. And I know a lot of people don't like the laundry in The Sims, but for me, I like the realistic aspect of it. So I really wanted to get a washer and dryer in here. So I do rearrange a few things, and I end up putting the toilet where that, I don't know, like that towel stand is. So I think you guys see that like later on, but if not, just know that there is a washer and dryer in there. So here's the upstairs landing, and I was just kind of messing around with a few things, and I do end up changing this all again too. Like I said, I was so just, I don't even know, like I couldn't decide, like there was just so much I couldn't decide. And actually I was watching another simmer, and she was talking about how like she liked to do base games a lot because it takes away from some of that struggle of deciding like what you want to put on. There's so many options, you know, when you have like all the packs between debug and regular menu, that it's almost overwhelming. So yeah, I end up changing this all out again. As you can kind of see off to the left, you see the child's bedroom, and it's done. And I loved that bedroom. It looks so nice. But the problem is that it didn't fit in with the rest of the house. And so if you see it, I'll put a picture at the end in the screenshot so you can see it, because it was a beautiful bedroom. It just did not fit in with like the country, the modern country style that I was going for. So I do end up changing things out, and I add these two double beds, and I did playtest this, and it works just fine. And then I got this trick from somebody. I don't remember what simmer I got it from, but there's like this little spice rack, and I sized it up and used it for, yeah, right there, and used it for the bed frame, and I thought it was so cute. It's such a clever idea. So in the bedroom, again, I was going for like this rustic, country, modern kind of feel. This is for a 10-year-old, and so what I wanted to do in this bedroom was really reflect a little girl growing into a young woman. And so there's parts of this room where there's like some toys, but there's also books and magazines, and you know, a little bit of makeup, but then there's also like a craft table. And so I really just wanted to kind of reflect a little girl who was growing up, and I just thought it was really sweet. We don't have that age group in The Sims, which is really unfortunate because, you know, preteens as it is, we really kind of get left out. And I have a preteen now, and he's really kind of gotten into The Sims lately, and so I think it'd be nice for them to kind of have like an age group in The Sims, and I feel like it'd be more realistic anyway. So yeah, I would love to see kind of like a preteen age group. I feel like they really just missed some opportunities by leaving that out. But yeah, so I put a mirror in here. Here's the little crafting table. And, you know, I've got these toys around. But also there's this little bit of sophistication, I feel like, about this room that I really, really enjoy. And I think, I don't know, I liked the previous room a lot. I really did. I love this room. I just love it. I feel like it fits with the rest of the house as well. I've also been really into creating like these little tent things and putting them in the bedrooms and putting like a little rug down there and some pillows where maybe, you know, I imagine obviously she won't really do that, but I imagine maybe she sits down there and reads. I put a little dollhouse down there and a toy box back there. Now they cannot get to the toy box, so if you know, you can move that around. It's really easy. Just move it somewhere else and they'll be able to access it. But yeah, here I am. And I just add a little bit of clutter onto the dresser. But I decided to make these little shelves right here that maybe kind of like hang from the wall. And I thought it was a really good idea. So I go through the debug menu. I use these shelves. I go through the debug menu, grab this like little metal pole thing. I size it down. And then I use the tool mod to kind of sit it at an angle. I've really been using the tool mod a lot lately, and I've been learning so much about it because when you get the tool mod, there's a learning curve. And creator of the tool mod actually put out a video. So if you ever download the tool mod, I really recommend you watching that video. It kind of explains how it all works. And there's still, even after watching that video, there's still a little bit of a learning curve. So just keep that in mind if you download it, but it's really a neat tool. It really is. And totally worth downloading. It never used to be a mod person until The Sims 4. And now I absolutely have to have MCCC, my reshade, and at least the tool mod. Like those are like my must have mods in The Sims. So as you can see, I stuck this mirror up against the wall. It's kind of standing there. And then I put some blue curtains in. I like having this little blue theme to it. And the bed is blue, so I feel like it just kind of pops. I put these other pictures up here. I also have these pictures like leaning up against the wall on these little end tables. And that was a lot of fun to do as well. Again, the tool mod is just, I love it. So it took me a minute to figure that out. But yeah, I feel like this is a bedroom that reflects the personality of a preteen child. So definitely let me know what you guys think. And like I said, I'll post pictures of the original bedroom that I made. And let me know, do you think that I should have kept the original bedroom? Or do you like this new one? Because I like them both, definitely. And I feel like this one just fits a little bit better than the other one with this house. So anyways, I clutter up the dresser here and just add a few more things on the shelves. I put a lot of candles throughout this house. That's another thing to keep in mind too. If you download this house, you can click on the candles. I think you can click on the candles and prevent them from like burning, because that was one thing that was like really frustrating to me, is when you're in live mode, the candles would just automatically burn, and then obviously they melt down. So I do like them for ambiance sometimes, but sometimes I like to just turn them off. So here in the kitchen, I really wanted to get that modern, rustic kind of vibe, country vibe in the kitchen. And so I use these counters, and are these, I think these are base game counters, I believe. And I go to the debug menu and I pull up these, they're like, it's like a canvas for your Sims to paint on. It doesn't interfere with the game at all. It doesn't interfere with your Sims using it. And I just felt like it makes a nice white front. And that's kind of what I was going for. I wanted like these white cabinets with this like wooden top. It's what I was really going for. And I looked at a lot of pictures on Pinterest to get sort of an idea of what I wanted, and I'm really, really happy with these counters. It took me forever to do. You guys don't see it because I cut it all out, but I am telling you, these counters were brutal. It took me just trial and error and just messing around things. So as you can see, I moved that in there, but it did, that did conflict with some of the things that my Sims would do. So I do end up changing it a couple times, and then I eventually move enough items around that I figure out a way to make them, to make it work. So yeah, I'm really pleased with them. I hope you guys really enjoy the counters as well. I think the ending result, I'm just super, super pleased with. And yeah, like I said, your Sims, it doesn't interfere with your Sims at all. I did forget to put a fridge in here. So Retro Sims actually caught that. I don't know how I forgot to put a fridge in here, but I did. Anyway, so here I use the tool mod again to use these like little sticks to put in a jar. I wanted to use a bunch of jars because I wanted to get the whole like, you know, maybe like mason jar type thing. There's just a lot of jars around the house with candles in them. And so as you can see, the counters are done. I used so much, and maybe I might do a tutorial on how I did those counters because I'm in love with them. And yeah, I just think they're gorgeous, and other people have commented on it as well. I also used these green cabinets from Parenthood because, I don't know, I just thought that it worked really good. And I used a green curtain in front of that sink, and the sink still works just fine, so your Sims can get to it, which I was actually really surprised about. And I just like the pops of green in here. It's just really, I don't know, I like it. I also like the shiplap on the backdrop, and then like the wooden, just like the wooden panel on the wall. I really love it. So I mess around with a lot of flowers. I wanted to put just a ton of like flowers in here, and there's just a ton of different decorations. I put a little mouse trap in here. I thought that was cute. I do add some pet bowls for the pets. And then I did not playtest that, and my Sim for some reason struggled getting to it. I don't know why. I don't know what was blocking it. Again, this was after I had all of the issues with the gallery. So I don't know, again, if that's a gallery issue, but we're going to get it all straightened out before we, like, I think what we're going to have to do is probably take the house down and get it all straightened out and then re-upload it. And we'll upload it, like, I'll upload it and then he'll upload it. That way, you know, you can find it on both of our galleries. But yeah, we really got to figure out what's going on with the gallery because I don't know, it's just, yeah, it was a mess. So anyways, yeah, I just hang up a bunch of decorations, and you guys know, again, if you've been here for a while, when I'm decorating, particularly kitchens, because there's so much stuff that you can put in kitchens, I like to just go through the menu and get out just anything that I think I might put in the kitchen, whether I end up using it or not. And I just like throw it on the counters or on the tables. And then I just go through one by one and just start adding what I like and what looks good. So, and that's something that, like, if you are new to building, or even if you're not new to building, I recommend trying that because it gives you a good inventory. And I've said this before, it gives you a good inventory of what you have in the catalog, and you can see it all together rather than spread out, and it just helps you kind of visualize how you want things to go. So yeah, the kitchen was actually the first room that I did downstairs, and I was really just, I didn't like how I had the floor plan, I don't think, in the beginning. And you guys will see like how it comes together. I feel like it just looks so much better. And I actually, so I don't know what I was doing here. Okay, I was just messing with stuff, and I'm just rearranging everything that I got out. And I put these little spices in this little rack above the stove, and I really love it. I just think it looks so good. And again, I think some of it was missing when I downloaded it from the gallery. So yeah, just hang in there with us, guys. But Anyways, I hope on a more personal level, I hope you guys are all doing well. In my last video, I kind of explained a little bit about, you know, how my life is going and just some of the struggle that I've had recently with not being able to upload as often. And I hope that that doesn't deter you away from me. But yeah, hopefully I will find a good schedule and I'll be able to upload a little bit more. But I definitely have missed The Sims. And I also want to know what you guys think of the new Paranormal pack. I have built with it and I've played just a little tiny bit with it. I haven't played a lot with it. So, you know, I can't really speak on gameplay, but I love the new furniture in this pack, which is something that I didn't think I would like. I didn't think I was going to enjoy this pack at all, but I think I do. I think I really, really enjoy this pack. So let me know what your guys' thoughts are on the new Paranormal Stuff pack. And also, The Sims is giving us a new update on the 25th, February 25th, I believe, for their 21st birthday. And they mentioned that it would be a collab. If you guys remember, like, a couple months ago, I think it was, The Sims actually mentioned that they were doing a collab with a singer, and, it was the K-pop singer. I'd never heard of her before, and so I'm really highly thinking that that's what we're getting for the 21st birthday. I don't know, though. That's just my theory. That's what I think. So let me know what you guys think we are getting for the 21st birthday, which, by the way, makes me feel completely old because I have been playing The Sims since Sims 1. So, yeah, I feel extremely old when I hear that The Sims is turning 21. I remember the first day that I ever even heard about The Sims, and, yeah, I was like 9 or 10. I mean, yeah, it's crazy. So, anyways, yeah, let me know what you guys think we are getting for the 21st birthday because I am curious, and that is just what I think it is. I really think it's going to be that collab with that K-pop singer, but I could be wrong. So here I am working on the dining room. I was going to at first leave it open, but then I decided to close it off and add these barn doors. These doors were a pain to get. I don't know. There could have been a better option for these doors. I don't know. I really liked these doors, and in the end, I feel like they look okay-ish. I don't know. I've seen people do better barn doors than me, but I'm pretty pleased with these doors, actually. I like how they turn out in the end. I love the orange color wood swatch that I used on them, and yeah, I'm actually pretty pleased with how they turned out. So I mess around a little bit with how I want them to look and, you know, kind of adding like a top piece to it to look like maybe it's on a track. I've seen other people do it and it looks really good, and yeah, I just mess around a little bit with it, and then I end up, you'll like see me cut it out, but I add these doors to each part of a room because the house was, again, I told you I didn't like the floor plan and it just felt very open and empty to me. So I decided to close it off and then add these barn doors, and I just feel like it added a lot of character to the house, and yeah, so this is how it ended up looking. Yeah, I really like it. And then, here in the dining room, I hang these, like, little lights, and I put all these decorations on it. I just thought it looked really good. It's just, like, this wooden light above their, table with, like, these plants hanging over it, and I think it just gives a lot of personality to the, dining room. I really, really enjoy the dining room a lot. I was going for kind of, like, a grayish brown, I don't even know, like, kind of vibe in here, and I end up hanging those, like, leaf, they're, like, little leaf things that you hang on the wall that came with, Eco Lifestyle, I believe, and I hang them in, like, the black and, like, gray swatch, and I don't know, it's just kind of what I was going for. I love these curtains, too, that I put up in here. I think they look really, really nice. I layered three curtains. Well, it's two different curtains, but I end up using three altogether. And again, I wanted to just put a place for your pet, and I end up moving the pet bowls over here. But like I said, I don't know what's blocking them in that spot or if it's just another gallery issue. But yeah, I had to move them. So keep that in mind. And again, we'll figure out all of the kinks when it comes to whatever's going on with the gallery. But I do end up putting a little end table here, and I think I put like the little chicken or rooster, I'm not sure what it, I think it's a chicken, in a little like bowl with eggs, and I thought it was really cute, like a little basket with eggs, and I just kind of like added that little bit of rustic to this like modern kind of dining room, I guess. I don't know, I really enjoy it, but yeah, I thought it was really cute, and I end up adding some, I believe, in the entranceway or maybe in the kitchen. I don't remember, but I love this dining room. I don't typically use a lot with, just like, I don't normally like create different things with the tool mod or with the debug menu, but creating that light, I feel like that's like, I'm super proud of that light. I'm super proud of my cabinets. Like this house, like I'm so proud of how it turned out. And it's crazy because I struggled and struggled and struggled creatively. Oh my goodness. I struggled so much. And finally, like one day I took a deep breath and sat down, and all of a sudden, like all this just came to me. I mean, this was like, I had not played it in days because I was so overwhelmed. And then I just sat down and bam, 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 it all came together. And I was so happy. I think I even like sent a message to Retro Sims that day, and I was like, I just got like super creative. So anyways, we are moving on to the entranceway, which again, I really, really love. I ended up putting a half bathroom here, which is what this wall is right here. Just, I feel like I wanted to have a bathroom downstairs for maybe like guests, but also I just wanted to do something with this floor plan. I don't know about this floor plan, man. I mean, I love how it turned out in the end, but I struggled with it. Until I figured all this out. But yeah, so when you first walk in, there's like a coat hanger, a coat rack, and then we've got these like little shelves with candles. Again, if you download this house, I recommend turning those candles off and maybe only using them if like your sim has a date over or something and you want to set like some ambience, but otherwise they're going to burn out and your sims are going to have to just keep creating more candles. And I've never actually played with that feature, so I don't really know how it works, but yeah, just keep that in mind. So anyways, I am just cluttering up the shelf. I put this little chair over here with these little lanterns. It's so cute, and you guys can see the barn doors, and I just love it. I'm so, so proud of them. And they were like glitching into each other, and I ended up fixing that too. So I'm elated with these barn doors. I just love them, and I don't know if they even look like real barn doors, but it excited me. And like, I was afraid that when I would release this that everybody would be like, what is that? And I'm like over here super excited about it. So if you guys look at it and you're thinking that, like, I'm sorry, but I really like them. So yeah. Over here, I decided to put a little sitting area. And again, I used the tool mod to turn these little stools into like pillows. And I thought it was so cute. This little blue like sitting chair. I don't know. I thought it was really cute. It'd be really cute in a bedroom too. But yeah, so I'm just rearranging them, like they're little pillows on here, and I just thought they were super cute, messing around with the tool mod again. Highly recommend that mod. It's amazing. I had a lot of fun with it, and again, there's just a learning curve, but yeah, I love this little like sitting area. Like maybe the kids could sit here and take off their shoes or get their shoes on ready for school in the morning. I'm not sure, but I thought it was really cute. And so yeah, I end up adding a few other things there. I don't know, I haven't had my sim try sitting on that yet, so I don't know if it's even functional, but that's something that honestly, if it's not, it's not a big deal to me. If it's a big deal to you, that's fine, you can replace it, but to me it's not that big of a deal. I didn't really, when I was making it, intend for it to be like functional. I was thinking more of it for decoration purposes. But as you can see, I've got some sunflowers when you first walk in, this beautiful little gray rug, which is like the same color rug that I used in the dining room. And here I am adding the little chicken and rooster, but I do think I end up moving those because it just felt really awkward right here. But yeah, I pretty much finish up the foyer, and that is pretty much it for the build. So again, I hope you guys enjoyed this build. Be sure to check out Retro Sim. He uploaded his version or his part of the build, so I will add his video at the end of this video. So be sure to check him out, subscribe to his channel, follow him on the gallery, follow him on Twitter, all of those fun things. And again, guys, let me know what you think in the comments down below of this home, and I will see you guys later. Bye.